Hello, it's me, Luigi, and welcome to LEGO Luigi Explores the Human Body. Today, we're gonna look at the urinary system. Let's go! Now, I'ma know what you're thinking. Luigi, why start out the series by talking about the urinary system? Well, let's just say I have my reasons. And here to help me is my friend Yoshi. Hello. Together, we're gonna take a look at the urinary system and what it does. Okay, so what is the urinary system? Great question. Let's see.
The urinary system is one of the ways our bodies get rid of waste. It does this by using the kidneys, ureters, bladder, and urethra.
And how does it work? Let's take a look. Is that the McHugh? Yes, Mario. Okie dokie. This watermelon is made up of over 90% water. They don't call them watermelons for nothing. Hey, Yoshi, that was for the video. Sorry. I was hungry, and that watermelon looked delicious. Oh, by the way, where did your cap go, Mario? Oh, I probably dropped it on the way over here. Okay. Now, let's get back on topic. We all need lots of water every day to keep our bodies running smoothly. Just like that watermelon, over 90% of the plasma, the liquid part of our blood, is made of water. Wow, that's a lot of water. But tell me, what does any of this have to do with the urinary system? I'm glad you asked. Water makes up most of our blood volume, and sometimes we need to get rid of extra water. That's what the urinary system is for.
First, blood travels to the kidneys where it gets filtered. Anything the body doesn't want, such as extra water, sodium, and urea, is taken out of the blood while everything else stays in.
And they call them kidneys because they look like kidney beans, right? No, it's the other way around. Every day, your kidneys filter 200 liters of blood, which is just under 53 gallons. That's amazing. So what is urea? I've never heard of that. Oh, urea is just a chemical the liver makes by combining carbon dioxide and ammonia, both of which are byproducts of chemical reactions that take place in the body. Ammonia is very toxic, so it has to be turned into urea or uric acid, depending on what kind of animal you are. Man, our bodies are clever.
Anyway, once all the extra stuff your body doesn't want is taken out of the blood by the kidneys, then it goes through the ureters into the bladder, which is like a storage tank for urine.
Urine what? No, I said the urine. That's a mixture of all the stuff the kidneys take out of your blood. Oh. As the bladder fills up with urine, the walls of the bladder stretch, sending a message to your brain that says, I have to go to the bathroom. That's right. That's when your body says you need to go to the bathroom. No, I need to go to the bathroom. Oh, okay, go ahead. Thank you.
Now, when the time is right, muscle fibers in the walls of the bladder push the urine out of the bladder into the urethra, which is like a tube that leads outside the body. This urethra is pretty short, so it must be a female urethra. The male urethra is much longer, and once Yoshi gets back, I'll explain why.
Many, many minutes later.
Shouldn't he be back by now? Yeah, I don't know why it's taken him so long. Why don't we just go on without him? Okay, this is gonna be on the internet after all. Now where were we? You were going to explain why the male urethra is so long. Alright, the male urethra is so long, yet it has more than just one job. We'll see what else it does in a later episode, but for now, let's just say that it lets us Paisano stand up when we go to the bathroom. And if you're watching, Yoshi, that's what the wiener is for. Well, I guess that does it for today's episode. Wait, shouldn't we explain what makes urine yellow? Oh, good idea, Mario. Urine is yellow because of a chemical called urobilin, which is made from the breakdown of red blood cells. You can tell if you've had enough water from the color of your urine. If it's a light yellow, you're okay. If it's a dark yellow, you need more water. Okie dokie, that should be enough for this episode. Yeah, I'ma think you're right. Thanks for watching, everybody. Make sure to like and subscribe to Luppet Central for more videos of me and Yoshi. The links to the research sources for this episode are in the description below. See you next time! I wonder what's taken Yoshi so long to get back.